This evening, they were gathered in an upper chamber, as commanded by the risen Lord, at the Father, of the Father, there is something one and more. When the Holy Ghost from heaven descended, like the rushing wind of tongues of one, so the Lord may sing by And then for the final verse and chorus, bless his name. Then will the Lord, then. Amen. You may be seated. Bless the Lord. Amen. Once again, would you make welcome the Tabernacle Choir as they come to minister.
Lord, let your light, light of your face, shine on us. Lord, let your light, light of your face, shine on us.
Thank you for the cross, Lord. Thank you for the price you paid, bearing all my sin and shame. In love you came and gave amazing grace. Thank you for
Pastor. Thank you, choir. Thank you, Kenneth. Thank you, Lorraine. That was lovely. Let's show them our appreciation once more. Will you turn with me to John's wonderful gospel? John's Gospel, chapter 14. And we will read the first six verses. John's Gospel, chapter 14. I want you to notice that he said all these things when Judas went out. John says he went out and it was night. And it was Judas's own momentum that took him out of that lovely floodlit room where he was having the Last Supper. But when Judas went out, it was then that the Master opened his heart to his disciples. He said, "Let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions." Remember taking this at a funeral one day, and the minister was at the funeral, a certain minister, and he came over and he said, "Young man, the translation is, in my Father's house there's many rooms." I says, "I know that, but I come from Spring Street and always wanted to live in a mansion." "In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you, and if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there you may be also. And whither I go, you know, and the way, you know." Now he's interrupted by Thomas. And this is where I'm going to bring my message tonight. And I'm delighted that Thomas, the melancholy Thomas, interrupted the Master. And this is what he said: "Lord, we know not whither thou goest, and how can we know the way?" Now listen to the answer. "Jesus saith unto him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me." And may the Lord tonight add a blessing to the reading of his own word. Let us pray. Father, you've brought people in from every walk of life and every circumstance and situation. We remember those that are in the nurseries as well tonight. Give them their portion. And grant all in the precincts of this great house that the Spirit of God may strike them and a great work will be accomplished in your lovely name. These things we ask for Jesus' sake. Amen. Amen. "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me." I am the way. Notice the Lord Jesus doesn't say, "I am a way." You see, there are many faiths, so-called, and many religions that say, "I am a way," so much that you can take your pick of any of them. But none of them tonight can satisfy the inner recesses of a man's soul and give him positive assurance that he is right before God and his sins are forgiven, and that his future destiny is that he will be in the presence of God for all eternity. But Jesus Christ, the Son of God, comes along and with one emphatic statement, sweeps them all aside, and he declares, I am the way. He is the only way by which a man can reach God and reach the presence of God. If you reject him, sir, if you reject him, lady, if you disregard him, ladies and gentlemen, you are rejecting and ignoring and disregarding God's only way into his eternal presence. Could I ask each of you a question that God's Son asked the religious leaders of the Jewish church just before his death on the cross? He asked, what think ye of Christ? I wonder what the reply would be if I went round every individual here tonight and said, what do you think of Christ? Listen to what God Almighty thinks of his Son. When he was baptized in the River Jordan, in Matthew chapter 3, he declared, this is my beloved Son, in whom I am well pleased. When he was on the mount in Matthew chapter 17 with Peter, James, and John, the Master declared again to those three disciples, this is my beloved Son, in whom I am well pleased. And then he adds three words, hear ye him. This is my beloved Son, in whom I am well pleased. Hear ye him. Now, if you reject him, you are rejecting God's only way. And whatever way you may decide to take to reach God, having rejected the way God has ordained to approach him through his Son, God will reject every way, sir, and every way, lady, that you walk on. You will be totally unacceptable to him. No matter how personally sincere you are, the Lord Jesus Christ, God's impeccable and sinless Son, is the only way to heaven and the only person who can forgive you your sins. It was Solomon in Proverbs 16 and 25, once regarded as the wisest man on earth, said these words, there is a way that seemeth right unto a man, but the end thereof are the ways of death. If you take any other way than God's way, which is the Lord Jesus Christ, you will be dead eternally, lost and separated from the presence of God. The prophet Moses, under the inspiration of the Holy Spirit, said to the nation of Israel, listen to the way he put it, behold, I show you the way of life, and behold, I show you the way of death. And that's what I am trying to do tonight, showing you the way of life and showing you the way of death. The Lord Jesus Christ is God's way of life. Any other way, sir, any other way, lady, however charming it may look, is the way of death. That's why Solomon stressed, there is a way that seemeth right unto a man, but the end thereof are the ways of death. Am I talking to someone tonight who has lost their way? Has lost their way in life? Who has lost their purpose in life? Your home's a mess. Your marriage has collapsed. Your children are disillusioned, insecure, and frightened. Life to you is a drudgery, one big, overwhelming difficulty that you can't accept and you can't cope with. Jesus Christ God's Son says to you, listen, I am the way. No matter what situation you're in tonight, no matter what problem that you cannot solve, no matter what circumstance you have found yourself placed in, he says to you, I am the way. Hear me, ladies and gentlemen. The man and the woman who will give their life to him and trust in his finished work in Calvary will know the way, for he is the way. So Christ says, I am the way. Christ spans the distance between heaven and earth. Christ spans the difference between God and the sinner. Man would fain manufacture a ladder of his own, and by means of his resolutions and reformations and his prayers and his tears and his self-righteousness, climb up to God. But that is impossible. That is the way which seemeth right unto a man, and that is the way that ends in death. Friend, it is Satan who would stubbornly keep you on your self-imposed journey to God. What faith needs to lay hold of is the glorious truth that Christ has come all the way down for sinners. Isn't that lovely? He has come all the way down for sinners. Oh, the prophet Isaiah in chapter 59 said, behold, the Lord's hand is not shortened that it cannot save, neither is his ear heavy that it cannot hear. But your sins and your iniquities have separated you and your God. But God sent his Son. He was the ladder. And he sent him, and he spans heaven and earth. The sinner could not come into God, but God in the person of his Son has come out to sinners. He is the way to the Father. He is the way to heaven. He is the way to God's eternal blessedness. Can I hear a praise the Lord? That is God's way tonight. Reject that and you're lost. But Pastor, my church says this and my denomination says that. We're not talking about churches tonight. We're not talking about denominations tonight. We're talking about Christ tonight. We're talking about what he said the night before he went to Calvary. He said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. Christ is the way. But if you will not tread that way, you shall not reach the end. A minister in America was going up the aisle of his church during a revival campaign when a young man earnestly cried out to him, sir, can you tell me the way to Christ? No, was the answer, very deliberately given. I cannot. The young man answered, I beg your pardon, sir. I thought that you were a minister of the gospel. So I am, was the reply. Then how is it that you cannot tell me the way to Christ? My friend, said the minister, there is no way to Christ. He himself is the way. Christ is here. Salvation is not a plan. I know evangelicals, and I have said it myself, God's plan of salvation. But there are many people who cannot read a plan. God's plan is in his Son. God's purpose is in his Son. If you want saved tonight, look at Christ tonight, because Christ is God's plan of salvation. He says, I am the way. But Christ says something else. He declares, I am not only the way, I am the truth. Not I have an element of truth. Nor does he say I have a monopoly of truth. Because if you have a monopoly of truth, that means you have much truth, but you don't have it all. No, he says, I am the truth. Absolutely, I am the truth. man came into my office many years ago, and he said, Pastor, this was on the church that we had up the Whitewell Road. I'll never forget it as long as I live. And neither will he. He came into my office, and I've told this many times, and I've used it to other people. And he rapped my door one morning, and he says, Pastor, I'm a searcher after truth. I said, Sir, your search is ended. Let me introduce you this morning to the truth. To his amazement, he expected me to reach him a theological booklet. Instead, I fell down before him on my knees and asked him to do the same and started to worship in front of him the Lord Jesus Christ. He stood there totally and absolutely amazed at me on my knees, my hands reached out, leaning on nothing, worshiping Christ and praising him. He said, I don't understand. I said, Sir, the truth is a person. The truth is not an abstract form. I said, the truth is a person. The person is God's Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Christ is the truth. Christ is the full and the final and the only revelation of God. That's why he said to Philip in our chapter, because Philip listened after Thomas's question was answered. He says, Lord, show us the Father, and it will suffice us or satisfy us. And Christ looked at him and he said, Have I been so long time with you, and yet you do not know me, Philip? He that has seen me has seen the Father. And how sayest thou then, Show us the Father? Believe me that I am in the Father and the Father in me, or believe me for the very work's sake. What was Christ saying to Philip? What was Christ saying to Thomas? What is Christ saying to everybody here tonight? He is saying that he alone is the visible expression of the invisible God. And I repeat, the truth is a person. But I want to understand the Bible, Pastor. You will never understand the Bible until you come and know the author of the Bible, the Lord Jesus Christ. To understand the Bible, you've got to know the author. And the Lord Jesus was standing before Pontius Pilate in his trial. He said to Pilate in John 18 and 37, now listen to this, he says, Everyone that is of the truth heareth my voice. Now that's a strange statement. Everyone that is of the truth heareth my voice. They that are of the truth hear God's word. They are of the truth perceive God's word. They that are of the truth feel God's word. And he says to Pilate, they that are of the truth heareth my voice. And a cynical Pilate asked him, what is truth? You see, you've got to understand that Pilate was a seasoned politician accustomed to lying. Hope I don't offend any politicians tonight, but politicians are accustomed to lying, accustomed to promoting lies, like the Blairs, like what has happened in the House of Commons, like what is happening in 10 Downing Street, what is happening, the spin doctors. Spin doctors are not new. Spin doctors were in Pilate's time. And Pilate says, what is truth? He was accustomed to lying, accustomed to promoting lies, accustomed to listening to lies, and accustomed to living lies. And he didn't know that the truth personified, the truth wrapped in flesh. The word of God himself wrapped in flesh, becoming flesh. was standing before him. Oh, he says, with his hands pinned behind his back whipped, a crown of thorns on his head, his face bruised, he says, art thou, thou pitiful looking Jew? Are you the king of the Jews? What? He was the king of the universe. Can I hear a praise the Lord? The king of the universe. And Pilate rejected him, who is the way, who is the truth, and who is the life, and crucified him. And Pilate tonight is lost for all eternity because he rejected the way. He rejected the way. Pastor, what about those who don't know the way? On that day when they stand before God, we have a merciful God. We have a just God. We have a kind God. God will judge people according to their knowledge. But you tonight know the way. You tonight know God's Son. And like Pontius Pilate, in darkness for all eternity, for he rejected God's truth, because God's truth is God's light. Friend, if you are confused with life, if you are disillusioned with people, if you are in darkness, Jesus Christ, God's impeccable Son, says to you, I am not only the way, I am not only the truth, but I'm also the life. Trust him, and you will never be confused. You will never be ashamed. You will never be disillusioned. Instead, you will be established for all eternity. For Jesus Christ, God's Son, is the light of God and the truth of God. But fourthly and finally, and you're listening well to me, and I want to get this over, he says, he's not only the way, he's not only the truth, but he's also the life. Let me be honest with you. There is another life apart from Christ. Some of you are living that life. I'm going to say that again. There is another life apart from Christ. And some of you are living that life. But that life is without quality. And that life is miserably inferior. It's a sinful life. It's a selfish life. It's a life that ends in a devil's hell. The life of sin always ends. Now, for me to say that there's no pleasure in sin, I would be a liar. There is pleasure in sin. The Word of God tells us tonight that there's pleasure in sin. Pastor, prove it. Hebrews chapter 11, it says, by faith Moses, when he was come to years, refused to be called the son of Pharaoh's daughter, choosing rather to suffer affliction with the people of God, listen, than to enjoy the pleasures of sin for a season. One of the marks of the last days in 2 Timothy chapter 4 is this, and the last mark is this, they shall be lovers of pleasure more than lovers of God. But sin ends. Do you know that sin pays out wages? That's why the apostle declares in Romans 6:23, the wages of sin. Note that term, the wages of sin is death. You may be enjoying yourself, that's fair enough, but sin hasn't paid out its wages yet. You're having the time of your life, so you think. And that time of your life is the life apart from Christ. So Paul says, the wages of sin is death. But then he adds, the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Certainly, don't be deceived. Sin will never give you life. At this moment, maybe it's giving you pleasure, but that pleasure is only for a season. The truth is, sin pays out wages, and on its payday, it pays out death. But the Lord Jesus declares in John chapter 10, the thief cometh not, but for to steal and to kill and to destroy. Notice this three-pronged attack. The thief cometh not but for to steal and to kill and to destroy. Now listen to this. But I am come that you might have life and that you might have it more abundantly. That's the sort of life Jesus offers, abundant life. Life with a capital L, filled with purpose, filled with direction, filled with quality. He offers you this life now, and he offers you this same life in eternity. He declares tonight, I am the way, I am the truth, I am the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. I'm closing, and I want you to listen to me carefully. Do you know that for the first 20 years in the infant church, or the apostolic church, if you want to call it, or the early church at Jerusalem, that church was known, now listen to me, it was known as the people of the way. Isn't that lovely? The infant church, the early church, was known as the people of the way. For instance, speaking of Saul of Tarsus before his conversion, it is recorded in Acts chapter 9 that he had warrants to arrest and bring into custody, notice the words, any of this way. Isn't that amazing? Wonderful, the lovely titles that God's people had in those days. The way people. The people of the way. Do you know how they greeted one another? By one word. Maranatha. Maranatha. And by this word, Maranatha, they knew who you were. And you knew who they were. Maranatha, the Lord cometh. Or the Lord is coming. They were the people of the way. And Paul received a warrant to bring these men and women to Jerusalem to put them into prison. But notice, any of this way. I am glad tonight to tell you that I belong to this way. Then if you go to Acts chapter 19 and verse 9, when Saul, who is now Paul the apostle, went into the synagogue, he found certain persons teaching and listening, speaking evil of that way. They were criticizing the way. They were ridiculing the way. They were despising the way. And to ridicule the way and despise the way is to despise the Lord Jesus Christ. Then if you let your eye go down to verse 23, of Acts chapter 19, we are told that when Paul went into Macedonia, there was an uprising in the city. Listen, an uprising in the city. What about? About that way. Oh, I would love an uprising in this city. Not up in North Belfast or East Belfast with burnings and buses being burned and children kept from going to school and all sorts of things happening. I would love an uprising in the city, a persecution in the city concerning the people of the way. A Catholic is not a person of the way. A Protestant is not a person of the way. A person of the way is a man and a woman born again by the Spirit of God. Person of the way. It's a man and woman who has come into contact with Jesus Christ and has had the blood applied to their hearts and has obtained mercy and forgiveness of sins. Then if you go to Acts chapter 22 and verse 4, Paul is giving his testimony before the Jewish council, and he says, and I persecuted this way unto the death. Not powerful. And I persecuted this way unto the death. And finally, if you go over to Acts chapter 24 and verse 4 again, He is testifying before the high priest, and he says, I confess that after the way they called heresy, so worship I the God of my fathers. What I am doing, you are saying it's heretical. What I am doing, you say, is heresy. What I am doing, you say, is wrong. But I know that I am worshiping the Lord Jesus Christ, and he's a wonderful Savior. What does God's people say tonight? Are you the people of the way? Isn't it terrible you hear believers saying, I don't know which way to turn. What's wrong with us? Turn to him. I don't know which way to turn. Turn to him. He is the way, the only way. And you know, Isaiah the prophet talks about when you go to the right hand and when you go to the left hand, you will hear a voice behind you saying, this is the way, walk ye in it. Isn't it lovely tonight? He is the way. I think this is beautiful, that the one who proclaimed, I am the way, now the men and the women who trust in him are called the people of the way. The one who said, I am the way, now that he has saved me, I am one of the followers of the way. Isn't it lovely tonight? All of us tonight, we are the people of the way. Will you, sir, tonight, will you, lady, tonight, become a follower? Will you become a member of the people of the way? Will you do that tonight? Will you trust him tonight? And will you serve him tonight and become the people of the way? Pastor McConnell, you sound very good, but you see, you're a preacher, and you have to talk like that. No, sir, I don't. Pastor McConnell, you're paid to talk like that. I have a word for you. This church pays bad wages. So if I'm paid to talk like that, they're miserable payers here. But you have to talk like that. I don't have to talk like that. Some of you are salesmen. Every now and again, you have to go to a seminar. Look this way, please. You have to go to a seminar, and the lecturer says to you, you've got to sell this product. Whether you feel about it or not, you've got to be convinced. You've got to sell this product. And you know rightly the product is a dead loss. You know rightly that the product is a defect. You know rightly the product has a flaw. You know rightly that the product you're selling, it's a lie. But you've got to do it because you're earning money. But I don't have to do this tonight. But I'll tell you here and now, from a boy of 7.5 years of age, I have found the way is wonderful. I have found he has never failed me. He has never let me down. He has loved me. He has cared for me. He has looked after me. He has strengthened me. Without him, I can do nothing, and without him, I am nothing. And so, I am compelled to tell you tonight, you know what compels me? The love that I have for him, and the love that he has for me, and the regard that I have for him, and the regard that he has for me. Put it in simple language like the Song of Songs, I am my beloved's, and he is mine. And that's what I am saying tonight. He says, I am the way. I am the truth. I am the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. But I've left a point out tonight, and this I finish. I am the way, the truth, the life. Muhammad's a way. Confucius is a way. Buddha is a way. Zoroaster is a way. He sweeps them all aside, and he says, I am the way. You know what a man said to me? Little shop at Serpentine Road. I used to get the morning papers. And he was an Anglican. And he fancied himself as a bit of a reader and a bit of a student. And you know, he went to the Church of Ireland. But he didn't believe one word the minister said anyway. 39 articles. Might have been 39 Mars bars. Knew nothing about it. And he said to me, "You're an evangelical." I said, "Yes." I says, "But I don't like the term evangelical because it's a title. It's become a denomination." I says, "I'm a preacher of the gospel." He says, "All right then, whatever you are, evangelical, preacher of the gospel." He says, "The one you're preaching about is intolerant." He says, he sweeps everybody aside and he says, "I am the way." I says, "He does." I says, "He can afford to." And he looked at me, he says, "What do you mean he can afford to?" I says, "I can take you to the grave of Buddha. I can take you to the grave of Muhammad. I can take you to the grave of Confucius. But when I take you to the sepulchre in Jerusalem, you'll find these words: 'He is not here, for he is risen.'" So he can afford to be tolerant. But listen, we've left out two important words. He says, "I am the way. I am the truth. I am the life." Now there's a history about "I am." You've got to go way back to Exodus chapter 3. There's a man in Midian. He has fled from Egypt 40 years earlier. He's married a wife. He lives in a black tent. He looks after the flock. Looks after the flock of his father-in-law, Jethro, the sheikh of Midian. He sees a bush. Catches fire. Seen that before. He walks away. Still burning. He looks at it. This bush is burning. And notice it says, "And the bush burned with fire, and the bush was not consumed." He walks away. He looks again. The bush is still burning, 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 burning. Looks, walks a long time away. It's still burning. And he says, "I have never seen this. There's no scientific explanation to this. What's the evolutionist going to say to this? What's Professor Huxley going to say here, that old reprobate? What's all these people going to say?" And he said, "I will now turn aside and see this great sight." And when he came near, God said, "Moses, draw not nigh hither. Put off the shoes from off thy feet, for the place whereon thou standest is holy ground." And a dialogue began. And then Moses said, "If I go to Egypt, they will ask me, 'Who sent me?'" And he said, "Tell them that I am has sent you. I am that I am, and I have sent you." So he says, "I am the way, the truth, and the life." Can I hear a praise the Lord? In John chapter 8, there's a confrontation by the Jews. And they say to the master, "What pedigree are you? We are of our father Abraham. We're not born of fornication." Did you see the wee insult, the wee slander there? They might have heard a rumor from the hill country up in Judea that a young virgin was with child and it was a Roman soldier that done it. That's what old Weatherhead and old Super said. That's what a lot of others, the old Bishop of Woolwich, every one of them's in hell tonight. That's what they said. That he was sired by a Roman soldier. How could you get to heaven after saying that? That's blasphemy against the Holy Ghost. And you know, young Mary, she said, "How shall this thing be, seeing that I know not a man?" And Gabriel says in verse 35, "The Holy Ghost said after me." Say it again. Say it loud. The Holy Ghost shall come upon thee, and the power of the highest shall overshadow thee. Therefore also that holy thing that shall be born of thee shall be called the Son of God. Now listen carefully. The Jews said, we are of Abraham, our father. Now listen to this. He says, your father Abraham rejoiced to see my day, and he saw it and was glad. I said, you're not even 50 years old. Do you know our master must have looked older than he was in the days of his flesh? They couldn't calculate his age. And they said, you are not yet 50 years old. And listen to the reply. Before Abraham was, I am. And they took up stones to stone him. And why? Listen to their language. For a good work we stone thee not, but for blasphemy, that thou being a man, makest thyself God. Boy, were they threatened with intelligence, because the one who said before Abraham was I am was God manifested in the flesh. And so he says tonight to this great congregation, I am the way. I am the truth. I am the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. Can I hear a praise the Lord? Forgive me for getting excited tonight. How can anybody not get excited when they talk about the Lord of glory? Blessed be his holy name. Have you lost your way? He's here. Have you lost your way? He's here. Are you disillusioned about people? You don't trust people anymore. Fair enough. He's here. He's the truth. Are you fed up with life and fed up with the conditions of life? He says, I'm here to give you a new life, a new quality. I am the life. Behold, I show you the way of life. And behold, I show you the way of death. May you respond to his word tonight for Christ's sake. Amen. Everybody said, will you bow with me in a word of prayer? Wonderful sense of God's presence in this great house tonight. While every head is bowed, every eye is closed, no one looking, only myself. Is there a man here tonight? Is there a woman? Is there a mother? Is there a father? Is there a grandfather, a grandmother? Is there a young man? Is there a young lady? Is there a boy? Is there a girl? Would you like me to introduce you to the way? Would you like to become a man of the way, a lady of the way, a boy of the way, a girl of the way? Would you like to become a family of the way? While every head is bowed, while every eye is closed, there's no one watching, only myself. Is there a person here tonight who would say, Pastor McConnell, I'm not right with God, but I want to be. Pastor McConnell, I have committed great sins. I want to tell you, sir, God can forgive you. Not only forgive you, but wash you in the blood of his son. Pastor, I'm in great trouble tonight. Let me tell you, the Lord is a very present help in the time of trouble. He is the way. He can make a way where there is no way. He is the way. Right now, while every head is bowed, is there a person here tonight who would love him, who would want him, who would serve him, who would say, Pastor McConnell, pray for me. I need to get right with God. I need my sins forgiven. I need Christ. If there's one in this house tonight, would you quickly and quietly lift up your hand and take it down again? I will see it and pray for you. God bless you right over there. Is there another one tonight? There's one up in the gallery. God bless you there. There's another one over there. God bless you. Is there another one tonight? There's one right over there. God bless you. Thank you. Is there another one? Just quickly and quietly, lift up your hand and take it down again. We will see it and pray for you. Is there another one up in that gallery? Down the sides, three people now have raised their hand. Is there another one tonight who will come to Christ and trust in the way? Is there one? Is there another? Quickly and quietly. God bless you. Thank you, sir. You may take your hand down. Thank you. Is there another one tonight? Four people now have raised their hand. Is there another one? Where are you? Quickly, quietly. Young or old, wherever you are. Doesn't matter what circumstance you're in. Maybe you're with someone and you're worried. Say, what would that someone say if I came to Christ? Oh, friend, make your personal decision here tonight. Lift up that hand. God bless you. Thank you, lady. God bless you. Thank you, young person, too. God bless you. Right over on my right there. God bless you. Is there another one tonight? Is there another one tonight? Just lift up that hand and take it down again. We will see it. We will pray for you. That's five people. Six people. What does God's people say? I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. I'm the bridge. I'm the one that spans. To walk to the Father, you walk in me. To climb to the Father, I'm the ladder. Is there another one tonight? Six people have raised their hand. Can I see your hand, sir? Can I see your hand, lady? Where are you tonight? Just quickly and quietly lift it up. Lift up that hand. We'll see it. We'll pray for you. Can I see it right now? Right now, just lift that hand. Right now, where are you? The deacons are watching out for you. May God help you tonight. We're going to sing Just As I Am without one plea. And I want every person in this building to sing it. I want the choir to sing it. Six people, is that six, have come to Christ. We're waiting on you, sir. We're waiting on you. Please, would you keep, don't have any distractions, please. Amen. Just be silent. And I want everyone singing here tonight, Just As I Am. Are you ready then? Come on. And I'm waiting on that hand going up. Come on. Just as I am. Is there another one tonight? Just lift that hand. God bless you right at the back. God bless you. God bless you. Is there another one tonight? Is there another one? Where are you, friend? Can I see that next hand? God bless you at the back, too. I see your hand. Two people now have raised their hand at the back. Aye. A lady came to me not so long ago, and do you know what she said to me? We're still in prayer. That's many, eight people now. She said, Pastor McConnell, I have my way and you have your way. I says, my way is God's way. And I says, your way is the way of death. She says, I'll take my chances because God knows my heart. I says, do you know what God knows what you are? I says, you're a guilty, hell-deserving sinner. And she says, how dare you? I says, you're a guilty, hell-deserving sinner. And if you reject God's lovely Son, that's where you'll be. Can I hear an amen from God's people? You are rejecting Calvary. You're rejecting His blood, His suffering, His coming into the world, His birth at Bethlehem, His growing up, His immaculate life. I'm waiting on you. And this is the final time that we're singing this song tonight, Just As I Am, without one plea. Are you ready? Everyone's singing. Come on. Just as. Is there one more tonight? Just lift that hand and we'll. God bless you, sir. God bless you there in the fourth row. Is there another one tonight? Come on. Where are you? Where's the next one? Can I see that hand? Where are you? Come on, where are you, friend? Can I see your hand? God bless you right over there. Thank you. You may take your hand down. Is there another one tonight? Oh, I am the way. I am the truth. I am the light. Is there a young person here tonight who would come to Christ? Is there a young person in this great service who would come to Christ? Some boy, some girl. Would you raise your hand? Is there some boy tonight, some girl who would come to Christ? Young, just like me, 7 and a half. Maybe 8, 10, wherever. Would you raise your hand? This appeal's dying out tonight. There's one right up at the top. God bless you. You may take your hand down. Thank you. Is there another one tonight? Is there another one? 11 people on this holiday Sunday has raised their hand to come to Christ. What does God's people say? This is the final time. And then we're closing. Would you sing it with all your heart? And I'm waiting on you, sir. I'm waiting on you, lady, to raise your hand and say, I'm coming to the way. I'm coming to the truth. I'm coming to the life. Are you ready, everyone? Just as I. Sir, one more tonight. Where are you tonight? Sir, one more tonight. Oh, there's a battle going on. He's the only way. Would you raise that hand? Raise it right now. Raise it right now. Is there one more person? It with you. Just give me a quarter of a minute. Is there a backslider here? And you've walked out of the way. You've walked out of the truth. You've walked out of the life. Is there a backslider? Would you like to come back to the Lord? Would you raise that hand? I've got to ask this. Is there a backslider tonight? Would you raise that hand? Raise that hand wherever you may. There's one over there. The deacons are pointing. God bless you. Thank you. God bless you. Is there another one tonight? Quickly. Is there another one tonight? Where are you? The deacons are watching out. Is there another one as I pray? Then, my friend, we'll leave that issue with you. And to God be the glory. What does God's people say? Would you put your hands out? Put your hands out like this. Let us pray this prayer. Are you ready? Father, I come to thee in the precious and worthy name of your beloved Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Thank you for sending him into the world. Thank you that he is the way, the truth, and the life. Take me as I am tonight. A guilty, hell-deserving sinner. And come into my heart. Come into my life. Come into my whole experience. And save me for time and eternity. Let the Holy Spirit lead me every day. Give me strength for each day. Open up my mind and my heart to your word. And teach me thy way. These things I ask in Jesus' name. Amen. Everybody said, Hands up who enjoyed this night tonight. Do you know, I enjoyed preaching on that text. I really did. It was lovely to be able to do it, to talk about him who is the way, the truth, and the life. Look at the clock. It's 8:15. Wasn't I lovely? I said you'd be out for 8:20. But before you go, we've got to sing Faithful God. Say Faithful God. Say it again. Are you ready? Everyone, come on. Faith.